मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स लेट अस कंटिन्यू विथ पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स टुडेज डिस्कशन इज द थर्ड वेरिएशन इन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ 15th ग्रुप एलिमेंट इज केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज In this, first one is oxidation state. The elements of this group exhibit both positive as well as negative oxidation states, and the common oxidation states exhibited are -3, +3 and +5. These are the common oxidation states exhibited by 15th group elements. In this, first one is negative oxidation state. Negative OS means oxidation state. Nitrogen exhibits negative oxidation state of -3. Nitrogen exhibits negative oxidation state of -3 on account of its small size and high electronegativity as compared with other elements. The nitrogen exhibits negative oxidation state of -3 on account of its small size and high electronegativity as compared with other elements of this group. And the tendency to exhibit -3 oxidation state is decreases down the group. The tendency to exhibit -3 oxidation state decreases down the group. Due to increase in their size and metallic character. The tendency to exhibit negative oxidation, that is -3 oxidation state, decreases down the group due to increase in their size and metallic character. Both are increases down the group. Next is positive oxidation state. The elements of this group exhibits positive oxidation states of +3 and +5. Elements of this group exhibits positive oxidation states of +3 and +5, and the stability of plus 3 oxidation state increases down the group and the stability of plus 5 oxidation state decreases down the group. The stability of plus 3 oxidation state increases down the group and stability of plus 5 oxidation state decreases down the group due to inert pair effect. Due to inert pair effect, the plus 5 oxidation state increases down the group and the stability of plus 5 oxidation state decreases down the group. The stability of plus 3 oxidation state increases and plus 5 oxidation state decreases down the group due to inert pair effect. In addition to minus 3, plus 3 and plus 5 oxidation state, nitrogen also exhibit plus 1, plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation states when it reacts with oxygen. Nitrogen can also exhibit plus 1, plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation states when it reacts with oxygen. Similarly, phosphorus is also exhibit plus 1 and plus 4 oxidation states in some oxo acids. Phosphorus can also show plus 1 and plus 4 oxidation states in some oxo acids. Then third one is disproportionation. Nitrogen and phosphorus also exhibit disproportionation reactions. And this third one is disproportionation. Nitrogen and phosphorus exhibits disproportionation reactions. In this, in addition to that is nitrogen and phosphorus exhibit disproportionation reactions with large oxidation states ranging from minus 3 to plus 5. The disproportionation reactions of nitrogen and phosphorus taking place with large difference in their oxidation states from minus 3 to plus 5. For example, in nitrogen, nitrous acid disproportionation takes place to form nitric acid and nitric oxide. The oxidation state of nitrogen atom in nitrous acid is plus 3 and in nitric acid is plus 5. And in nitric oxide is plus 2. The disproportionation reactions taking place in nitrous acid from plus 3 oxidation state is converted into plus 5 with increase in 2 unit of oxidation state of nitrogen in nitric acid and with decrease in 1 unit in N. Similarly, in case of phosphorus, for example, H3PO3, phosphorus acid undergo disproportionation reaction to form phosphoric acid H3PO4 plus PH3, this is called phosphine. In this is phosphorus acid, this is phosphoric acid, this one is phosphine. The oxidation state of phosphorus in phosphorus acid is plus 3. The oxidation state of phosphorus in phosphoric acid is plus 5. And in phosphine, oxidation state of phosphorus is minus 3. The disproportionation reaction taking place in phosphorus acid to phosphoric acid and phosphine, the increase in the oxidation state by 2 unit, that is plus 3 to plus 5, and decrease in oxidation state, that is plus 3 to minus 3. And the tendency to exhibit disproportionation reaction is decreases from arsenic to bismuth. The tendency to exhibit disproportionation reaction is decreases down the group from arsenic to bismuth. This is due to greater stability of plus 3 oxidation state. Greater stability of plus 3 oxidation state. Tendency to exhibit disproportionation reaction is decreases from arsenic to bismuth due to greater stability of plus 3 oxidation state. Next, last variation in the 15th group elements is anomalous properties of nitrogen. Nitrogen exhibits anomalous behavior as compared with other elements in the same group. And some of the reasons for anomalous behavior of nitrogens are a very small size, high ionization enthalpy, high electronegativity, and absence or non-availability of vacant d orbital in the valence shell. These are the reasons for anomalous behavior. Reasons for anomalous properties are, first one is a very small size. Second one is high ionization enthalpy. Third one is high electronegativity. Then last one, absence of d orbital in its valence shell. These are the reasons for anomalous properties or behavior. These are not anomalous properties. The anomalous properties are shown because of these reasons. Next is anomalous properties or point of differences with nitrogen and other elements of the group. Anomalous properties or point of difference between nitrogen and other members. In this first anomalous property of nitrogen is p pi multiple bond. Nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond with same element because of its small size and high electronegativity, and as compared with other elements, these do not form p pi multiple bonds. Nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond due to its small size and high electronegativity. Whereas other elements of this group do not form p pi multiple bond. Only nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond with the same elements. This is because a very small size and high electronegativity. The size is increases down the group and electronegativity is decreases down the group. That's why only nitrogen can form p pi multiple bond as compared with other elements of the 15th group. Second one is covalency. The maximum covalency of nitrogen is only 4. Maximum covalency of nitrogen is 4 only. Because the absence of vacant d orbital in their valence shell, there is only 4 orbitals are available for the formation of bond, and those 4 orbitals are 1, 2s and 3, 2p orbitals. Only 4 orbitals are available for the formation of bond, and the maximum covalency of nitrogen is only 4, but whereas other elements the covalency is expanded up to 6. While other elements covalency expanded up to 6. Then third one is hydride of nitrogen, that is ammonia, is more stable as compared with other elements of hydrides. Hydrides of nitrogen, that is NH3, is more stable while other hydrides are less or not stable. The hydrides of nitrogen, that is called ammonia, is more stable as compared with hydrides of the 50 other hydrides of the 15th group elements. These are the less or not stable. Then fourth one is atomicity. Nitrogen is diatomic gas at room temperature, while other elements of 15th group, that is phosphorus, arsenic and antimony, these are the solid in tetraatomic state. Nitrogen is a diatomic gas at room temperature, whereas other elements are tetraatomic solid state, that is P4, AS4 and SB4. Last one is the single nitrogen-nitrogen bond is weaker than that of single phosphorus-phosphorus bond. The single nitrogen-nitrogen bond is weaker than single phosphorus-phosphorus bond. The single nitrogen-nitrogen bond is weaker than that of single phosphorus-phosphorus bond. This is due to strong inter-electronic repulsion on lone pair of electron on nitrogen. Due to strong inter-electronic repulsion of lone pair of electrons on nitrogen. The lone pair of electrons on nitrogen are more repulsion, and the single nitrogen-nitrogen bond is more weaker. And one more point I forgot in the chemical properties of 15th group elements, that is second one is covalency. The maximum covalency of nitrogen is only 4, because absence of vacant d orbital in the valence shell, and there is an only availability of 4 orbitals to formation of bond. And whereas other elements like phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, their covalency is expanded up to 5 and 6 because of availability of vacant d orbitals in their shell. Examples: examples of covalency nitrogen covalency is only 4. Whereas other elements, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, for example, the covalency is 5 and 6. Examples for this is PCl5, AsCl5, PF6, SbF6. These are the examples for expanded covalency up to 5 and 6. Next is trends in chemical reactivity. Trends in chemical reactivity. First one is reactivity towards hydrogen. This is formation of hydrides. Trends in reactivity. First one is reactivity towards hydrogen, or the formation of hydrides with the 15th group elements. The elements, all the elements of 15th group reacts with hydrogen to form hydride of the type EH3. All the elements of the 15th group reacts with hydrogen to form hydride of the type EH3. E means elements of the 15th group, where E is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. When the elements of 15th group reacts with hydrogen, these forming hydrides of the type EH3. And the hydrides of the 15th group elements are, when nitrogen reacts with hydrogen form hydride, that is NH3, it is called ammonia. When phosphorus reacts with hydrogen for hydride, that is PH3 called phosphine. When arsenic reacts with hydrogen form hydride of AsH3, this is called arsine. Antimony reacts with hydrogen form hydride, that is SbH3, this is called stibine. Then last, that bismuth reacts with hydrogen forming hydride, that is BiH3, this is called bismuthine. These are the hydrides of the 15th group elements, that is nitrogen hydride is ammonia, phosphorus hydride is phosphine, arsenic hydride is arsine, antimony hydride is stibine, and bismuth hydride is bismuthine. All these hydrides are, the geometry of all these hydrides are in pyramidal shape. These are pyramidal in shape, that is the shape of the hydrides of 15th group element is pyramidal, and the structure of pyramidal shape of hydride of 15th group element is like this. In this, some of the properties are explained in the reactivity towards hydrogen. In this, first one is thermal stability. Thermal stability of hydrides of the 15th group elements. The thermal stability decreases down the group. The thermal stability of hydrides of the 15th group elements decreases down the group. The thermal stability decreases down the group. The reason for this is, while moving from nitrogen hydride to bismuth hydride, the EH bond strength is decreases, and due to decrease in their EH bond strength, because of increase in the size of the 15th group element, the thermal stability decreases. Reason for this is, the EH bond strength decreases down the group due to increase in size of the 15th group element. And the order of thermal stability of hydrides of the 15th group elements is like this. Order NH3, PH3, AsH3, SbH3 and BiH3. The thermal stability of 15th group elements decreases down the group. Next one is, second property, second property is basic nature. all the elements of this group acts as a Lewis base. All the elements of 15th group hydrides acts as a Lewis base. All the hydrides of this group acts as Lewis base. All of you already studied what is Lewis base and Lewis acid. Lewis base is nothing but the species which donates a pair of electron readily. These are called as Lewis bases. And Lewis acids are nothing but the species which accepts the pair of electrons readily. Those are called Lewis acids. And all the hydrides of this group acts as a Lewis bases, and it decreases down the group. The basic character of hydrides of 15th group elements decreases down the group, and ammonia is most basic hydride. Ammonia is the most basic hydride among the hydrides of 15th group elements, and the basic nature or basic character is decreases down the group. Because the reason for this is the basic character decreases down the group. Reason is, as the size of the central atom like nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, size of the central atom increases, the tendency to donate pair of electron is decreases, and consequently the basic character is decreases. As the size of the central atom increases and its tendency to donate a pair of electron is decreases, or the density of electron density on the central atom is decreases, that's why the basic character is decreases down the group. As the size of central atom increases, the electron density on central atom decreases, and consequently its tendency to donate pair of electron decreases down the group from nitrogen, that NH3 to BiH3. The basic nature is decreases down the group because the electron density on the central atom decreases down the group, and its tendency to donate a pair of electron decreases down the group. That's why the basic nature decreases, and its order is NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3 and BiH3. Third property is reducing property. The hydrides of the 15th group elements, the reducing property is increases down the group. The reducing property or reducing character or reducing nature of the hydrides of 15th group elements increases down the group. Reducing nature increases down the group. The reason for this is the reducing property of hydrides of 15th group elements increases down the group. The reducing property or reducing nature is mainly depends on the EH bond strength. While moving from NH3 to BH3, the EH bond strength is decreases and the reducing property is increases. Reducing nature depends on EH bond stability or EH bond strength. On moving down the group, EH bond strength decreases due to increase in their size. The reducing nature is mainly depends on EH bond strength. On moving down the group from NH3 to BiH3, the EH bond strength decreases due to increase in their size. That's why the reducing character of hydrides of 15th group elements increases down the group and their order is NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, BiH3. In these hydrides, ammonia is least reduced, it shows least reducing property, and BiH3 shows strong reducing property. Then last one is boiling and melting points. Boiling and melting points of hydrides of 15th group elements increases from phosphorus hydride to bismuth hydride. But in case of nitrogen hydride, ammonia shows ammonia has highest boiling point than that of phosphine. Ammonia has a highest boiling point than phosphine and increases down the group. There is an abnormal boiling point of ammonia is due to strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding is exist in ammonia, and due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding the boiling point of ammonia is higher than that of phosphine. From phosphine to bismuthine the boiling point is increases. Reason for this is in ammonia strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding is exist. In ammonia strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding is exist because of high electronegativity, and whereas other hydrides the electronegativity is decreases down the group and the hydrogen bonding tendency is decreases. That's why the ammonia has highest boiling point than phosphine because of strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And the order is PH3, ASH3, SBH3, BiH3. In all these properties of hydrides of 15th group elements, thermal stability decreases down the group, basic strength is also, or basic character is also decreases down the group, then reducing property increases down the group, and similarly boiling as well as melting point of 15th group hydrides also increases from phosphine to bismuthine. But the abnormal boiling point of ammonia is due to strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding exist in ammonia molecule. Next one is second one. Reactivity towards oxygen or formation of oxides. Next, trends in chemical reactivity. Second one is reactivity towards oxygen. All the elements of 15th group reacts with oxygen to form two series of oxides of the type E2O3 and E2O5. When 15th group elements reacts with oxygen, these forming two series of oxides of the type E2O3 and E2O5. E is nothing but elements of 15th group, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. In this, the oxides in higher oxidation state of an element is more acidic than lower oxides. The oxides in the higher oxidation states of an elements are more acidic than the lower oxidation states of an elements. The oxides in the higher oxidation states of an elements are more acidic than the lower oxidation states of an element. And second point is, their acidic character decreases down the group. Their acidic character decreases down the group, because the acidic character of oxides of these series decreases down the group, because the plus 3 oxidation state, stability of plus 3 oxidation state increases down the group, and plus 5 stability of plus 5 oxidation state decreases down the group. Next point is, the oxides of the type of E2O3, the oxides of the type E2O3 of nitrogen and phosphorus are purely acidic, comma, arsenic and antimony are amphoteric, and bismuth oxide is predominantly basic in nature. The oxides of the type E2O3 of nitrogen, that is N2O3 and P2O3, are purely acidic in nature, whereas the AS2O3 and SB2O3 are amphoteric, means these two oxides exhibit both acidic as well as basic character. And last one, that is bismuth trioxide, is predominantly basic in nature. And in addition to, for example, in nitrogen, in addition to E2O3 and E2O5, nitrogen can also exhibit different oxidation states of oxides. Like in nitrogen, NO, N2O, NO2, N2, O4 also exist. And some of the oxides of nitrogens like N2O3, N2O5, N2O4, NO2, N2O and NO, and these oxides are arranged according to increasing order of their acidic character. The acidic character is depends on higher oxidation state of an element is more acidic than lower oxidation state of an element. In this, the highest oxidation state in these oxides of nitrogen is that N2O5, that is plus 5 oxidation state. In this, plus 3, plus 2, plus 4, plus 1, plus 2. These are arranged according to this is plus 4. N2O5. Is more acidic than
NO2, then N2O3, then NO, and last one N2.
The oxidation state of these elements is decreases like this, and their acidic strength is more in N2O5 than NO2, N2O3, NO, and N2O. Third reactivity is reactivity towards halogens or the formation of halides. When 15th group elements reacts with halogen, these forming two series of halides of the type EX3 and EX5. The elements of 15th group elements reacts with halogen. X is nothing but halogen, E is nothing but elements of the 15th group, and these reacts with halogen forms two series of halides EX3 and EX5. In this, nitrogen does not form pentahalides. Nitrogen does not form pentahalides. EX3 is nothing but trihalide and EX5 is nothing but pentahalide. Nitrogen does not form pentahalide. Why? Because nitrogen does not containing vacant d orbital in their valence cell. Reason for this is absence of vacant d orbital. In their valence cell. In their valence cell, there is an absence or non-availability of vacant d orbital, and it does not form pentahalide. Second one is bismuth is also does not form pentahalide. Bismuth is also does not form pentahalide. Reason for this is the stability of +5 oxidation state decreases down the group due to inert pair effect. Stability of +5 oxidation state decreases down the group due to inert pair effect. Due to inert pair effect, the stability of +5 oxidation state decreases. That's why bismuth also does not form pentahalide. Then last point is pentahalides are more covalent than trihalides. Pentahalides are more covalent than trihalides. Reason for this is pentahalides are more covalent than trihalides. Reason for this is the higher oxidation state of an element exhibit high polarizing power.
Higher oxidation state of an element exhibits high polarizing power.
Due to higher oxidation state of an element exhibit high polarizing power, the pentahalides are more covalent than trihalide. Higher the polarizing power, higher is the covalent character. Then last one is fourth one, reactivity towards metals. All the elements of 15th group reacts with metals to form a binary compound of -3 oxidation state. All the elements of this group reacts with metals to form a binary compounds of -3 oxidation state. For example, when nitrogen reacts with metal like calcium, it forms Ca3Na2, that is calcium nitride. This is called calcium nitride. When phosphorus reacts with calcium, forming calcium phosphide. And these are the examples for reactivity towards metals. When metals react with 15th group elements, these form a binary compounds of oxidation, -3 oxidation state. For example, when calcium reacts with nitrogen, forming calcium nitride. Calcium reacts with phosphorus, this is forming calcium phosphide.